Welcome to the House of Love. You like to dance and listen to the music.
I want an album to feel like a slice of life. I want it to address a lot of different things because I think the biggest challenge in life is to live as a whole person. And I want an album to be an experience in that. I'm the
look you want. With a little luck and lots of hard work, Amy Grant has emerged as a major force in pop music, having sold over 20 million albums in her musical career. Her current CD, House of Love, is a project she hopes embraces her audience.
I hope House of Love provides a space in the listener's head, in their heart, to just, you know, experience some of the good things in life, to ask a few questions. I think music creates space, that's what it does, you know, because life kind of presses in on all of us. But somehow a song lifts the pressure off a little bit.
Vince Gill took the pressure off Amy Grant when she recorded her duet hit, House of Love. The song was supposed to be a single release, but Amy needed a high note that could only be delivered by country star Vince Gill.
When he sang, it was magic. And we had a film crew there because we were documenting making the record, but everybody just went, ooh.
Yellow Taxi is Amy Grant's latest single, a song first sung by Joni Mitchell in the 70s. Grant hopes this 90s version will help the environment.
We've worked it out so that part of our proceeds for all of our summer show tickets are going to go to national parks. It just feels like a holistic approach, you know?
Grant's musical career has survived the test of time. Her first pop album, Heart in Motion, produced several hits, including a number one single.
Well, I wrote Baby Baby for my first daughter. So, you know, what a great sentimental song. It was a fun thing to share with her. And I think when all of my children are grown, my other kids are going to go, and our songs? Thank you.
Some people think I only have two records out, but I've got a lot of old music that means a lot to me.
Amy has been part of the music scene since she was 16. She was enormously successful in gospel music. We believe in God. She decided several years ago to cross over to mainstream pop and endured a lot of criticism for that decision.
I had friends saying, oh God, you're just gonna embarrass us all because you're touted as being, you know, one of the biggies in gospel music, and if you fail in the big arena, what it does is diminish our credibility here. And I thought, when did making music become about the big picture and credibility? I thought it was about making music, really, you know? Baby, that's what
love is for. Love from her family, friends, and fans gives her the strength to do what she does best.
The audience gives me a chance to do what I love, to sing. You know, they've supported my music for a long time, so I get to keep doing it. I really feel a sense of that I'm singing to friends that I've had for a long time. And I think the audience feels that way too.
For today, Sarah James, NBC News, New York. Just